Welcome back, friends. Today's session we are going to cover circuit breaker. In the last session we have covered a retry mechanism, how to use a retry mechanism in microservice environment, okay, part of fault tolerance. Today we are going to cover circuit breaker. Implementation perspective, circuit breaker is very similar to a retry, okay. Let me open report service. I have already implemented. These are last method. In the last video, I used this endpoint for retry, right? Now I'm going to use this endpoint for circuit breaker. We have one annotation called circuit breaker. In the circuit breaker, we have to tell what is the default configuration. It's a default configuration, it's a default, and the fallback method is a whatever method you want to return. Here I am saying show error. This is a show error. Whenever this call is not working, what will happen? This default method will go on the print. Now, when you look at very high level, the circuit breaker and at retry, both are looks very similar, right? There is no difference. Whenever failure this particular call, it will go on to call the show error, give the response. This response will go to the client side. Okay. Now, what is the behavior of circuit breaker? Let's understand that first. Okay. Before that, I'll show the demo. What is the URL we need to call? We need to call this URL. To call this method, we need to use this URL, right? I already make it account service as account service one. These are wrong. Definitely, it will fail. It will go on to call this method. Let's check that. I need to give number, account number. So this is the default response. This is the default response called. Okay. This is the default response called. One minute, I'll call again. I'm refreshing it. This is the default response. See the log. It's calling. This is API call method. This particular endpoint is calling. Since it's failed, it's going to our default method. The default method return. This is default response. This string is returning. That string I am printing in browser. So it's very, very similar to retry. Looks like it's very, very similar to at retry annotation. But there is a big difference between at retry and at circuit breaker. Okay. Let's explore that now. Go to our Reference4j site. Click the circuit breaker. The circuit breaker has three different state: closed state, open state, half open state. It has three different state. Let's say you started your microservice environment. You are using circuit breaker, one of endpoint. In our case, we are using our reporting service. We are using in this endpoint, we are using circuit breaker. Now your circuit breaker is a closed state. Now whenever you call the account service from the reporting service, your account service give the response, or it may give the error. This state is called as a closed state. Whenever you get the proper connection, your accounting service give the proper response to the our reporting service. If you have any connection issue, whenever call the account service from the reporting service, your account service cannot give the proper response, it throws some error. In such a case, what will happen? It will give the error as well as it will give the default response. Okay, here. So whenever call this account service, it will give the error. It will go back to here and then return default response. This is called as a closed state. Let's say it's keep on happening. Keep on you're not able to connect. Let's go to the some properties here. This is a circuit breaker property. See here, failure rate threshold 50. That meaning, let's say you are calling 50 times account service. If you're calling 100 times in that 100 times, 50 times is not working. 50 times giving some error response. So that meaning it's calling the API as well as we're getting the default response. So 50 times reached. Once I reach the 50 times, what will happen? Your circuit breaker go back to the open state. Go back to the open state. That meaning whenever call the account service, it never call the API. It never call the API. It will call only a default method. It will call only a default method. That meaning your threshold reached, your threshold properties reached, what will happen? It will never call this API. Automatically, it will go on to call this method. It never call this API, automatically go on to call this API. That is called as a open state. That is called as a open state. Okay, now we need to find out our server is up or not. We have to find out, right? For that, what will happen? Our circuit breaker sent some percentage of requests to the real server. For example, let's say you are calling 10 times. In the 10 times, it will send a 3-time real request to our account service. If your account, this state is called as a half open. This state is called as a half open. Please remember, if your threshold reaches 50%, for example, you are calling 100 times, 100 times you are calling, in which 50 times giving failure, so it's reached our failure rate threshold, so it going back to open state, that meaning we are calling only default method, we are not calling actual API, that is circuit breaker not calling actual API, not hitting the API, since already our server is down, it's not calling the server, it's calling only default method. Okay, next step is we should know server is up or not. For that, your circuit breaker sending some percentage of request. For example, let's say you are sending 50 requests. In the 50 requests, is sending 10 requests to the real server. This state is called as a half open state. Half open state is nothing but in a 10 calls, it will send 3 calls to the real call. 7 calls, it will call the default response. In the 3 calls, it gives the proper response. It will go to again closed state. It will go to again closed state. In the half open state, it will sending some request to the real server. If that request gives some proper response, it will go back to closed state. If still your server not providing a response, proper response, what will happen? It will go back to the open state and then again it will call only default method. Again, it will call only default method. This is the behavior of circuit breaker. Okay. So again, I'm repeating, there's a 3 state. The first state is a closed state. That meaning whenever call the API, in our case, we are calling account service from the reporting service. If the account service is not responding, we are getting error response. Then, since we are getting error response, we are calling a default method. Circuit breaker calls the default method. So here, we are getting error response as well as it's calling a default method. In the closed state, we are getting error response from the API as well as calling a default method. Open state. Circuit breaker never calls the real API. It will call only default method. Half open state. Half open state nothing but, let's say user sending a 10 calls. In the 10 calls, circuit breaker pick only 2 calls. That 2 calls only sent to the account services. If the account service provide proper response, it will go back to the closed state. If account server is still providing an error, it go back to the open state. This is called as a half open state. Now we'll going to see this scenario practically now. Okay. Now I'm going to show the circuit breaker demonstration using this method. Here I am calling a account service, right? Before that, I want to show the properties. If you want to customize our circuit breaker properties, you can use resilience 4j circuit breaker instances, then default. What is your configuration? Here I am using default configuration. Okay, default configuration. So I am using the same default, then minimum number of calls. minimum number of calls 25. That is, going back to the properties, circuit breaker properties, see here, failure rate threshold 50, that is, if failure rate reaches 50%, then only it will go to open state and call the default method. But I don't want to wait such a long time, because I am calling this method, right? This reporting service method, I am calling this reporting service method in another REST application. There is a REST call, this is a RESTful application. In this method, I created a one REST endpoint. In this application, I created one REST endpoint called a do call. Okay, it's a get mapping. In this get mapping method, I am created a one for loop. It's iterating 1000 times. And each iteration, I am calling that particular reporting service endpoint. I am calling reporting service endpoint. That is, if the failure rate reaches 50%, that means 500 times. After calling 500 times, then only it will go to open state. Okay, I don't want to wait till that time. I want to make it faster. So, what I am doing here, in this properties, I am saying that minimum number of calls. If 25 calls, continuous 25 calls failure, then go to open state. Automatically, it will go to open state. Okay. That is the meaning of this particular property. So, my REST call. The REST call is my RESTful web application. In this, I created a one endpoint. This endpoint call reporting service 1000 times. If failure happen, it will go to open state, it will go to off open state, it will go to go back to again open state. That scenario we are going to see because of this particular call. Okay, I will going to explain by showing the log. Okay, so first 25 call, it will in the first 25 iteration, it will call the API as well as the default method. It will call the API and as well as default method. After 25, it will never calls the API because it's moved to the open state. It will call only the default method. After some time, what will happen? In half open state, it will send some request to the real server. That time it will call API as well as default method. Still, if you are getting the error, again, our circuit breaker calls them only default method. That scenario we'll going to see now. Okay, I'll going to start the application now. Then reporting service also not started. I'll going to start the application. Reporting server started. Also, risk call server that also started. Okay. Now I'll clear this log. Now I'm going to call the risk call web services. What is the endpoint of risk call web services? localhost API, then 9095, port is 9095. Okay, this is the call I need to invoke. Let me check the console. Let me open the console. Now I'm going to call. Hit enter. See, it's calling now API under default method. Now only default method. See, only default method is calling now. I will explain it after completion of this call. Let's keep on calling now. Keep on calling only default method. It's not calling real API. See, now it's calling API as well as default method. Now it's calling only default method. It's not calling real API. let's complete this. Still it is calling. Yeah, call is done. 1000 call is done. Now going back to the top of our logs. See here, com.it garden report controller. This is API call method. This is API call method. That is the reporting service. The API call is invoking. That particular log is printing. Then after that, since it's failed, it's calling the default response. Okay, understand that it's calling API method as well as this is the default response coming from here. Default method response. Okay, so here you can see here it's calling API as well as a default response. Skip on calling up to 25, it will call because I given 25, right? Up to 25, it will call after completion of 25 times. Now it's calling only default. This is the default response. It never calls the API. It's circuit breaker never calls this API because it's giving the error. What is the use of calling that API? So it's calling only default method. It's keep on calling only default method to the client. So it's keep on calling. Now I come down. Now this is, I want to see, this is called as open closed state. This is called as closed state. Still server is down. It's going back to the open state. The open state is calling only the default method. Okay, it's calling only default method. Now again, see here, again, it's calling the API. Now it's going back the half open state. Some of the requests sending to the real server. Still that server giving the error. Okay, not giving the response. So again, it's going back to the open state. If server is works fine, it's going back the closed state. Okay, in our case, never go to the closed state. It will go always open state. Okay, now it's going to open state. Again, it's calling the default method. It's not calling the real method. Okay, this is the behavior of circuit breaker. Okay, I hope you understand the behavior of circuit breaker. Please try yourself. If you have any question, please let me know. Okay, in the next chapter, we'll going to see bulkhead. Okay, bulkhead we'll going to see bulkhead or rate limiter we'll going to see in the next video session. Until then, bye bye from Suresh. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.